With Hannah Montana cereal on the market, kids may pester their mothers to buy it. But should moms give in and buy a product laden with corn syrup? What we know as table sugar used to be king. Then this tasty syrup flooded the market. Medical doctor Dana Flavin.
It tasted good. It was sweet. It was a good substitute, an inexpensive substitute for sugar, and we didn't have to rely on imports of sugar. We could just go ahead and use the corn syrup.
The government helped make corn syrup an even bigger hit with manufacturers and consumers. Corn subsidies helped make it cheaper. Plus, tariffs and quotas doubled the price of table sugar. And high fructose corn syrup has a longer shelf life, a boon for manufacturers. Those advantages led to widespread use from sodas and other drinks, to whole grain breads, to even many spaghetti sauces. Cardiologist Steven Sinatra.
It's everywhere. It's in all our foods. And even myself, I mean, I struggle and read those labels all the time. And I'll tell you a story the other day when I ate something and there was high fructose corn syrup in it, and I got rid of it immediately.
When the corn syrup wave started, Flavin worked in the foods division at the Food and Drug Administration. For years, she had no concerns about the sweetener until she needed research for an article.
I was floored. Because I didn't want to believe it. And I'm a toxicologist from FDA and a physician. And I'm thinking to myself, oh, this is ridiculous. It's just corn syrup. I wish it were just corn syrup and just that simple. It's much more complicated.
Flavin and Sinatra think excessive table sugar and corn syrup are both bad. But they say recent research shows corn syrup is worse. The reason is unclear. But it appears that the manufacturing of corn syrup makes it chemically different than table sugar. Another problem with high fructose corn syrup is the fructose itself. The body processes fructose more slowly than other sugars. In the liver, the body turns fructose into fat rather than burning it for energy.
And so you start developing what they call fatty liver. Now, fatty liver can later on start changing also into a less effective liver that's not functioning properly.
A fatty liver encourages weight gain. Flavin says fructose compounds obesity by increasing hunger.
And this is the problem. So you do eat more, and then you have more, a greater appetite, because your body's saying, I haven't had enough. And your body's being fooled, essentially, by a whole chemical imbalance.
Sinatra, the cardiologist, says in that same process, insulin, the body's sugar manager, goes haywire.
High fructose corn syrup is very sweet. It elicits an insulin response. And when it happens, remember, insulin is the number one risk factor for cardiovascular disease.
That means deadly strokes and heart attacks. And of course, insulin problems are at the heart of diabetes and all its health complications. A study of diet and this type of diabetes over past decades found increased corn syrup consumption and less fiber intake helped increase type 2 diabetes by a factor of 20. Flavin worries about what's happening to the nation's children. Kids and teens consume more corn-sweetened soft drinks than any other age group, and that makes them much more likely to develop diabetes. The fructose in the corn syrup interacts with the carbonation to form substances called carbonyls. Carbonyls are not only toxic, but have been linked to cell damage leading to diabetes in children. For children born in 2000, the lifetime risk for developing type 2 diabetes is 30% for boys and 40% for girls. Sinatra says most doctors don't recognize high fructose consumption as the cause of health problems in adults. Instead, they treat symptoms like high blood pressure or high cholesterol as diseases in themselves.
He or she may prescribe drugs when only the best treatment is loss of weight, exercise, and restriction of simple carbohydrates, sugars. And high fructose corn syrup is a top of the list.
Flavin says we can't ignore the degradation to our health.
When you start seeing these changes over time, and you start seeing this in the animal models, and then you start seeing the American population becoming more and more obese and more diabetes, we really need to start reevaluating this.
Experts say any fructose in your diet should come from eating whole fruit, in moderation. But for optimal health, put a lid on the sugar in general and stay away from the most dangerous kind of sugar, high fructose corn syrup. Galen Tethero, CBN News.